It's time now for Countywide, a special presentation of Yavapai Broadcasting News. Join News Director Paul David and News Editor Philip Catafamo as they talk with our community's leaders, newsmakers, and people in the know. You'll hear about the hot topics in Yavapai County that affect all our lives. And now, here's today's Countywide.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of Countywide. I'm your host, Philip Catafamo. I'd like to thank you for joining me. On today's show, we are talking about Sedona Fire, and we are speaking with the new Fire Marshal, Dori Booth. Dori, welcome onto the program.
Thank you. It's glad to be here.
Well, we're really happy to have you. You took over for John Davis recently. You've been in the position for a little bit now. First and foremost, let's just get a general. How you doing? How you liking the job so far? Are you liking the Red Rocks of Sedona? How's it going at Sedona Fire for you?
It's amazing. It's everything I think I could have hoped for, honestly. Yeah. Like, the department's been welcoming, our partners throughout Verde Valley, the locals in Sedona, and getting to learn everything. So it's been amazing.
Yeah, it's an absolutely gorgeous area too to be working in too. Sedona is so nice. I've gotten a chance. Anyway, it's right, stone's throw away from where we're at, but it's very pretty is my point, I guess. But I want to get into, Dori, your background in fire. I know you come to us from Illinois and also from Phoenix. You worked in the Phoenix Fire Department for a little bit. We'll talk about that. But what inspired the career choice? How did you get started in fire? Can you take us through kind of your decision to start this career path?
Yep. So ever since I was a little kid, I've always wanted to be a firefighter. My grandfather was a fire district board member back in Illinois in a small town. And then my dad was also a career firefighter, retired as a battalion chief a few years ago. So it's always been in the blood to be in the service industry as well as public safety, really. Yeah. And it's never really changed. There was a moment in time where I thought I might have wanted to be an engineer, but ultimately ended up going to school for fire investigations and then fire protection engineering. So it's been here the whole time.
Yeah, it seems like it's in your blood almost, mm-hmm. You've got a family connection to just the fire industry in general. And I know you also served time in our military, so thank you for your service. Can we talk a little bit about your experiences? I know you'd, reading from your bio, it said that you'd seen some action in Iraq and Kuwait, along with Afghanistan. We won't go too deep into it, but I'm just, what was that experience like for you? What made you choose to serve? How does it differ from your current job?
Yeah, well, first, thank you. It's my pleasure to serve, and it was definitely kind of contouring towards life as well. And started out, military was always something that I had wanted to do too, next to fire, but never really lined up. And I knew I wanted to get through college first because I had heard the horror stories of, you're going to get into the military and you're never going to finish your education. And so I started that when I transferred to Eastern Kentucky University from Lincoln College in Illinois. I didn't know anybody, and it was like mid-semester, that winter break switch. So I joined ROTC and then so decided to stay there. How I ended up in Iraq and Kuwait, Afghanistan. So in ROTC, when I had to do a senior internship with the fire department program, and that's how I ended up in Phoenix, which I think we'll talk about a little bit mm-hmm. later. But when I made the decision to stay here, I had to make the decision to enlist in the military or pay back the Army for all the schooling they had paid through ROTC. So went ahead and decided to enlist. In 2007, I went to Kuwait and Iraq with a transportation and sustainment unit. Did accident investigations for anything that was non-combat related from northern Kuwait to southern Iraq. And then 2012, we came back or went to Afghanistan as a civil affairs team sergeant, where we were working with the local populations in Ghazni province, kind of doing instability assessments to see how we could help improve their environment.
So you get out of the military. Is this when you decided to go work for the Phoenix Fire Department?
No, it was actually simultaneously. Okay. So I was a reservist that just managed to deploy quite a bit throughout the entire time. I was an intern with Phoenix Fire in 2004. As part of my fire program from Eastern Kentucky University, went to basic training in 2005 and then got hired full-time 2006 with Phoenix.
Okay. And can we talk a little bit about your time in Phoenix? Do you have any fun stories, any interesting calls that you got a chance to go on? Anything come to mind regarding your time in Phoenix?
It was always interesting, especially being one of the fifth largest city in the country. You never really knew what you were going to get handed, but appropriate to the time of year as it's cold right now and you see a lot of space heaters. One of the most memorable calls I can remember going on was an apartment fire where there was a space heater in a child's room next to her bed, and her comforter had actually fallen off and started a fire. Well, thankfully that the home, they had their door closed like they were supposed to. The smoke alarms were working, but also the unit was sprinklered. So the sprinklers actually went off and gave her enough time to get away. So it was one of those where, and I still get goosebumps thinking about it, because not very often do we get to see the work that, a fire prevention person or fire marshal team gets to do.
Right.
And that was a prime example of exactly why we talk about our safety messages and really look towards having sprinklers. So I think for that, that's probably one of the most memorable, is just knowing that, you know, everything worked like it was supposed to and they had a really good outcome.
We have a lot of reoccurring guests and segments on the show, and one of which that we always hit every year is our summertime travels, you know, driving safety, making sure you don't park over any kind of, you know, tall brushes and make sure you get your vehicles inspected, but also the winter safety show. Mm-hmm. We always talk about, you know, like you just said, people I know the comforter fell on top of the space heater, but we always emphasize, you know, hey, make sure there's no materials near the space heater. Make sure that that your doors are closed. That's a great point. I remember watching that video, and I always thought that keeping your door open was good because, you know, you can escape a lot easier, but having that door closed, the fire obviously hits the door first. You can see the smoke coming underneath the door as opposed to it creeping inside your room. But we always try to hit the fire prevention stuff, and you're right. It is nice to see some of that stuff kind of come into fruition and hear some people really, you know, making sure that they're taking the proper steps to not die in a fire at their house or prevent a fire just in general. But you get an opportunity to come up here to Sedona. Did you always have plans to be a fire marshal? Did you always kind of want to work your way up, potentially even to be a chief, and then maybe go on to the fire boards when you're done with your career? But what attracted you to the position in Sedona? What kind of sparked the career change? Like I mentioned, have you always wanted to be a fire marshal?
So I have, actually. So ever, it really started out with me wanting to be a firefighter, and then it between deployments and just timing, it never really happened. So I'm pretty sure like things happen for a reason, and what's meant to be is meant to be. I was off on leave when the Sedona Fire District fire marshal position opened up recovering from COVID. Mm-hmm. So I'd been off for a little bit. It's like, oh, you know what? It's like, I'm really looking for a career change and a promotion. I was a deputy fire marshal with Phoenix, and then our assistant fire marshal positions had been recently filled, so the opportunity for moving up was pretty limited for a few years in Phoenix, and I was ready to take the next step in my career.
Yeah.
So I put in for this, and the planets aligned from the moment that I walked in the front door at Sedona Fire District. It really felt like home.
I've got a chance to talk with a few of the representatives at Sedona Fire, and I want to say this first and foremost. I think we have a lot of fantastic fire departments here in the entire state of Arizona, and a lot here in the Verde Valley. But whenever I've gotten on the phone with your predecessor, John Davis, or I'm probably using that term wrong, but you took over for John Davis. Speaking with John, Carla as well, both of them are always great. I've spoken to a lot of Sedona Fire battalion chiefs before. Obviously, you and I have met before. We met at John Davis's retirement ceremony, and you're fantastic. But it seems like that entire department, like you said, that feeling of home, whenever I needed John to call me back, he always would. Even if I wasn't there, he'd always make sure to give me a call back and leave a voicemail. Same with Carla, same with Jordan Baker, all the BCs and the PIOs there. You and I are sort of working out that communication chain a little bit, and you know, it's nice that we get to collaborate a little bit more, you know, directly. And because I think you guys are fantastic fire department, and really, you guys have some fantastic people working there, genuinely.
Thank you. And I feel it too, only being there for just now about 4 weeks. You know, it's small, but it's big. You know, and it's a family, where a lot of times in the big municipalities and jurisdictions, you just kind of get lost in the numbers. When you have 2,000, 3,000 members, it's hard to know everybody. And here, I mean, within a few weeks, we had a member that just had a baby. So we get to know everybody, and it really is a family.
Yeah, that small town feel here in the Verde Valley, it's quite wonderful. I also come from a more populated area, and coming down here, where kind of everybody knows each other, it's it's nice. You know, it just sets for a very, very good atmosphere and a good community. But if you want more information about Sedona Fire, their website is sedonafire.org. They also have a Facebook page. You can check that out. Their phone number is 928-282-6800. Of course, in any kind of emergency, please dial 911. We're going to take a break. When we come back, we'll talk a little bit more specifically about what Dori Booth does as a fire marshal and fire inspector right here on Countywide. Stay with us.
Who doesn't dream of home improvements? Perhaps your kitchen, the real living room. Maybe the bathroom, where you bookend your day. Langstrand Contracting is your one-stop shop from tear down to finishing touches. With 35 years of experience, Chris and his team will work with you to match your family's style and budget. Call Langstrand Contracting today for guidance in bringing your vision to life.
Award-winning Soundbites Grill is an entertainment restaurant located in Uptown Sedona at the Hyatt Pinion Point Resort. Open for lunch and dinner, featuring fresh fish, all-natural hand-cut beef, even a full vegan menu. Family-friendly, open 11:30 to 9, late dining on Friday and Saturday. Soundbites Grill has some of the best views of the Sedona Red Rocks. Offers world-class entertainment, food, fun, and music.
Your carpet is the largest air filter in your home, trapping dust, dirt, and germs from the air that your family members breathe, even the furriest ones.
That's why it's important to keep your carpet and tile clean and hygienic with regular cleanings by Zero Res. Zero Res uses state-of-the-art technology and ZR water, not soap or harsh chemicals, so zero residue is left on your home surfaces.
Schedule your appointment today, because a clean home is a healthy home. Visit ZeroResNorthernArizona.com.
The mouth is the gateway to the digestive system. Studies indicate a correlation between oral health and full body health. Regular cleanings and checkups can help protect you. New patients are welcome at Arizona Smile Designers in Cottonwood. There's a full smile worth of services all offered under one roof, whitening and cosmetic to implants and smile reconstruction. Find out more or request an appointment online at azsmiledesigners.com.
Welcome you back to Countywide. On today's show, we are talking about Sedona Fire, and we are joined by Fire Marshal Dori Booth. In the first segment, we talked a little bit about Dori coming to us from the Phoenix area and working with Sedona Fire as their new Fire Marshal and Division Chief. Beautiful area in Sedona, of course. Dori, I wanted to talk a little bit more about maybe some of the goals you have while you're here. I don't know if there's some, I know you're still very new to the position, so we're not going to see any major changes. I don't think we really will see any like significantly crazy changes, like you guys changing the name or anything like that. But I'm just curious, do you have any goals set aside for yourself, any goals set aside for the department that are known that you want to kind of accomplish during your time here?
You know, first, honestly, like John Davis, the previous fire marshal, I'm truly blessed to be able to come in and try to fill his shoes. You know, he did a lot of groundwork to improving the department and the Fire Prevention Community Risk Reduction Division. So really, I want to continue building on the programs and the relationships that he did. One of them was bridging the gap between the firefighters and the fire marshal's office. You know, there's always, nationwide, there's always a little bit of a gap between the two, because a lot of people see fire marshal as the person that wants to ruin the fun. And
we were talking about that a little bit, yeah.
You know, and that's really not the case, you know, and then you have firefighters that they want to go put out the fire and you know, the camaraderie that's a little bit different, because typically they're on shift here, they're on a 48-hour shift, and then they're off for 96 hours, where fire prevention's kind of day in and day out, or only see them when things go wrong. And
right.
And when that's one of the big goals, is to continue building that relationship and incorporating how community risk reduction and the fire marshal's office can help the firefighters and vice versa, and you know, keeping them in the loop and helping each other. Because ultimately, one of the big goals of fire prevention, it's not to shut people down. I mean, we want everybody's business to be open and safe, especially after the long couple years that we've had of, you know, businesses having to pivot their profiles and now allowing people to come in.
Right.
We just want you to be safe, and ultimately we want it safe for the firefighters too. And
Well, you know, we talked a little bit about that off air, just sort of, you know, this perception that the fire marshal is the guy flipping the lights on at the, you know, the 80s party. You know, you see that in some of those movies. But I got a chance to speak with a lot more fire marshals since taking this position here. And you guys do a lot of planning. There's a lot of the science behind just fire investigation is fantastic. You know, meant just kind of knowing where a fire started, where it ended, how it started, how long it had been burning. All of that stuff is fascinating to me. I'm incredibly afraid of heights, so I would never be a fireman just because it's just, I can't handle being on a ladder. But I there's so much more to just this position than just going out and putting out fires. You know, I mean, I've talked with other fire marshals. They've told me about business plans for buildings that are coming up that they have to consult on. You guys go to a bunch of meetings. I mean, there is so much more to this position than, like you said, just kind of shutting the party down and going, well, you don't have the proper sprinklers. And it's like, well, there's a reason why you need these sprinklers, and we need to talk about that. But I wanted to ask a little bit about the training required to become a fire marshal. Can we dive into that a little bit? You know, what's required of you to sort of know the position before you take it?
Yep. So I think every jurisdiction is a little bit different on what their requirements to get into the fire marshal's position is. But a few things that are kind of standard across the country is, you know, you really want to start as an inspector, I think, or a firefighter and working through the bureau. So you understand how codes are related to fire operations and public safety and where the codes come from. There's one of my past bosses, a fire marshal, and it's true, codes are written in ash and blood. Mm. You know, there's always a catastrophe that has triggered a code requirement. So understanding the science, like you said, behind it of how fires work and how can you prevent them. And ultimately, you know, hopefully our office doesn't have to do investigations. That's our primary goal, is to prevent them and keep everybody safe prior to. But there's a lot of college classes that you can take, fire science, intro to fire science. I know Yavapai Community College has quite a few of those.
Yep.
And trying to do ride-alongs when those come back. Some of the entities will let you ride along with fire inspectors and operations. For fire marshal, there's a lot of certifications. You need your plans examiner, inspector certifications, fire investigation certification. A lot of political savvy too, because you're working with high-level officials on very controversial items that cost a lot of money, because it's really hard to prove something's worth when something doesn't happen.
Right.
And really, that's a good thing for fire prevention and the community risk reduction section, is if something doesn't happen, we're doing our job. But justifying that in a way to make people understand why they're spending money is really hard. So becoming, you know, that strategic level and being able to explain it is hard.
Fire codes written in ash and blood. That is a pretty metal response, I have to say. I love that. That's fantastic, because it's true. I mean, that's really what it is. You know, a lot of laws and a lot of fire codes and a lot of, you know, sort of the don't do's are because somebody did it, and we're like, well, you shouldn't do that. And a lot of fire prevention is a lot of the don't do's because somebody did it, you know? Mm-hmm. You're right. I mean, that's a perfect way to put it. I mean, realistically, it's written in ash and blood, and that's unfortunate, but you know, that's how we learn. But you guys do a lot, as I mentioned, just as fire marshals. You know, you talk a little bit about, the figuring out, you know, where this fire started and stuff like that. But, you know, what else do you guys do? I mean, are there any other misconceptions that you want to clear up? We talked a little bit about those. Is there anything else that people should know about the position that they may not? Just real quick.
Oh yeah, so we do a little bit of public information, we do education. A lot of times the fire prevention weeks, we go to the schools and we work with the children. We do a lot of humanitarian type things. We do have some charities that we can talk about in a little bit.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's really kind of everything that's not involving fire and EMS is what our office touches, and it's touches things for years to come.
Yeah, no, very much so. Again, we're going to continue our conversation with Sedona Fire Marshal Dori Booth on the other side of this break. But just briefly, again, SedonaFire.org is their website. 928-282-6800 is their phone number. Again, dial 911 in an emergency. We'll continue talking with Dori Booth right here on Countywide. Stay with us.
Terrifying jobs, Bull Rider, take two.
Cliff, this seems like a really terrifying job. Why do you do it? I love protecting the bull riders when they get bucked up.
How big are these bulls?
12 to 2,200 pounds of pure muscle.
You're not cowed by any of this, obviously. Is there anything that scares you?
Yeah, distracted drivers terrify me.
Two things we can count on every year.
A new set of tax rules and great weather here in northern Arizona.
Jackson Hewitt Tax Service, locally owned and operated by Lewis Rice since 1997, is here for you all year long.
Your neighborhood Jackson Hewitt Tax Office will help you in all of your taxing situations.
Electronic filing is always free with your tax preparation at Jackson Hewitt Tax Service.
Get more in return. Call 1-800-234-1040 for an office near you.
The EPA says C&B Construction ranks in the top 1% nationally. C&B Construction invites you to see what energy efficiency and indoor air quality can be. We have won another Department of Energy Innovation Award, and C&B Construction is the only contractor in the country to win 6 consecutive EPA Indoor Air Plus Awards. Experience our zero-energy, move-in ready homes at Crossroads at Mingus.
C&B Construction, locally respected, nationally recognized. Find out more at C&B.com.
Award-winning Soundbites Grill is an entertainment restaurant located in Uptown Sedona at the Hyatt Pinion Point Resort. Open for lunch and dinner, featuring fresh fish, all-natural hand-cut beef, even a full vegan menu. Family-friendly, open 11:30 to 9, late dining on Friday and Saturday. Soundbites Grill has some of the best views of the Sedona Red Rocks. Offers world-class entertainment, food, fun, and music.
I want to welcome you back to Countywide. On today's show, we are talking about Sedona Fire, and we are joined by new Fire Marshal and Division Chief Dori Booth. We talked a little bit about Dori's origins coming to the Verde Valley from Phoenix. She's originally from Illinois, but she has an extensive fire career, also served some time in the military, so we talked a little bit about that. We also talked about what it takes to become a fire marshal. Dori, we've got just a few minutes here. You mentioned charities. I'd love to talk a little bit about some of the charities that Sedona Fire supports, or honestly, any that the community and Sedona Fire support. So if anybody can help with monetary value here, I don't know. But are there any that you want to throw out there?
Right now, we're still working with Toys for Tots for the holidays. This past week, we actually did a bicycling event where the team is a crew of 12, actually rode about 450 miles collectively between them. We're at about $1,400 of our goal for 5,000, so about 30%. We're still collecting money up until the 16th of December, so we can hopefully get kids toys this weekend. We actually worked with Toys for Tots and got some bicycles and safety helmets and taught them how to ride their bikes with a lot of training wheels with the elementary school. So hopefully, you know, we can reach our goal before the holidays hit to be able to help the kids around the community.
What about other events? Is Sedona Fire hosting any other events? I know you mentioned the Toys for Tots, but any outside events that you guys are a part of that you want people to know about?
Right now, I'm not too sure. I'm still getting my feet on the ground.
Of course.
Definitely, you know, as those come up, we'll reach out with you. I'm wanting to get, you know, more involved in the community. You know, and if there's any way that, you know, we can help you out or the community also, just reach out and we'll see what we can do.
Well, Dori, I appreciate you coming on and giving us a little bit more insight about your job and your background and coming on. You replace a great fire marshal in John Davis, and I think so far they've got an excellent replacement for him. I'm really happy that we got a chance to meet in person, because the first time I met John was at his retirement ceremony, which is nobody's fault, but it's great to get a chance to collaborate with you and a lot of the other great fire representatives we have here. So again, thank you very much for coming on the show and spending some time with us and talking a little bit about your job. Welcome to Sedona. I hope you're here for a very, very long time, and I hope you're able to accomplish everything you want to. But seriously, thank you again for coming on.
Thank you, Phil.
Yeah. Again, if you want more information about the department, SedonaFire.org is the website. 928-282-6800 is their phone number. Again, in an emergency, please dial 911. That is today's episode of Countywide. I'm your host, Philip Katafman, wishing you a great rest of your week. We'll see you next time.